decision making? How does that work?
So we do have a statutory duty to ensure that you consult as part of your consultation due to that on your license.
Okay. So now the recommendations.
That is approved.
And we also take in, of course, we're approving the area that I've been saved.
Agreed.
All in favour?
All these engineers and parts. So there's the the statements of accounts, and then there was the annual looking statement, the statements, and there are some separate things.
But we must approve them all.
We have to approve both signatures, really.
So can we, sorry David, go on.
I wanted to ask a non-political question, just related to procedure really. Jeff has drawn attention on 278 to the slightly inadequate statements concerning ensuring all officers receive performance appraisals. It's 98% in fact. And if there's issue with children's services, from a legal and technical point of view, should those two amendments not be included in the government statement? I'm just asking. I'm asking the legal officer if that's correct. Because we've raised those points, and if we sign this off without those two things included that Jeff has raised, then to me there's something illegal about what we're signing. That's not a part of political statement, it's a question related to reality.
Okay, we've got the question.
Thank you, Chair. So, speaking by the point, which can either be taken on board by officers in terms of the recommendation for you, or indeed the meeting plan making this formal.
You will amend this recommendation to include those 2 points.
Is that a draft?
Yes.
It's a draft.
It's a draft and it's approved by the committee.
So I'd like to say the same thing, Chair. It's clarified this is a draft set and a draft statement. It remains draft until such time as you vote.
Yeah.
So we should add that to it.
Yeah. Well, I think it makes more right, but I think there are so many different points. I'm content to agree the financial statements for the Jenny does, that's okay. But I'm personally intent to vote against the annual report statement. Because again, the other thing here, ensuring consultation is positive for future development, just doesn't happen.
Jeff, just put that in the form of to be surprised about, so I'll be in the second of the room.
Chair, what we're being asked to do, so currently, you've been given a set of recommendations on the block, which is to approve the accounts for the pension fund, approve the accounts for the statement of accounts for the council, consider the notes of the audit findings of our committee, for the section of our office to sign the data letter of representation, including which is approval of the annual government statement. So the moment on block that's being requested at the meeting is to take those in parts and more specifically to adopt all of the financial elements as one and take as a separate vote the agreement here on the government side. So it's well on all meetings happen to do.
Thank you very much for making that really clear because I think a lot of us will be
I'm happy to support the same thing.
And my amendment, therefore, would be that we separate out the annual report statement.
Is there something else that wrong? Is what you're proposing accepting the qualifications that was just given this budget?
Councillor Jeff Green has made his proposals to the chair.
Yeah.
and actually voted on first. Not to succeed then to my second proposal before that.
Well,
first of all, Councillor Green didn't make proposal that actually got in first was because it puts the meeting whether or not to take this in part. And the proposal was put forward that it wasn't taken in part, but it wasn't taken in single vote. Chair, it's a very quick procedural vote. So what is proposed at the moment is the recommendations are taken on block. So if members vote in favour, it's taken with one vote of all items. If that's voted down, then we move to the suggestion of Councillor Green, which is the vote is then taken on
block. Is that moved and seconded and taken on
block?
And then just to be absolutely clear, I was trying to develop the most consensus around most of the items within this. If the Labour Party don't want to find that consensus, then that's a matter.
Nevertheless, there's a proposition before us. Those in favour, please shout to the leader. And those against, please shout.
Purchased the Cllr financial management model, which is a diagnostic tool, which looks at four specific areas.
one-to-one interviews and group interviews with the cross-board council to come to an agreement really from CIPFA as to where we are in terms of our financial resilience and financial management. That they have produced a draft report and I'm actually looking at that at the moment. What I intend to do is bring that report back to the committee once it's been finalised. There are some areas in here which are the strengths and weaknesses, which are the high level strengths and weaknesses that we've actually brought out. We already have an action plan ongoing to make sure that we can demonstrate an evidence really how we're financially resilient and financially sustainable. One of the other things that we are looking forward to, CIPFA have actually launched a consultation on the financial resilience index, which effectively pitches all councils countries against each other and produces a RAG rated bar chart. So it will mark or sort of rate where Wirral is against all the other countries in the country to give us an indication in terms of our retrospective look, so it is using retrospective data as to where we are within that sort of indicator and index range. And as a result of that, that will give us a good indication as to where we might need to target some more assurance or evidence to